Goradus, you hardly know us. Pause for laughter. Hi, I'm Duke of the Bump. Welcome to Let's Play Popful Male Redux, episode number 8. And this is the first boss of the new era of Popful Male. We just defeated the Thunder Dragon, which is as far as I got in the previous LP before my computer died unexpectedly. And this boss is going to be a little trickier than the Thunder Dragon. Most bosses in this game fall into two categories. There are the ones you can cheese, and they're really easy. And there are the ones that you just have to be really patient for, like the Wood Golem. And with Goradus, it requires a lot of patience. First of all, if you don't attack, he won't do anything at all except slowly walk forward, and then eventually slowly walk back. He won't even attack you unless you attack him first. And when you do attack him, there are three different things that he can do. He can jump up in the air and stomp on the ground, causing stalactites to fall. And your only defense for that is to run to the left, pretty much as soon as it looks like he's about to do that attack. So get a couple hits in on him, see how close that was. If I had delayed, then I would have taken a lot of damage there. Like I'm about to. Nope. That's surprising. That's his other attack, the fireball. I've gotten lucky so far. The temptation to press your luck. Oops. See, there I should have continued running left instead of standing around waiting to see what he was about to do. But the temptation to press your luck and try to get more shots in than you should is really strong. And you have to ignore that temptation and run to the left as soon as it looks like he's about to do something. If he does a fireball, it's no big deal because you can just block it with your shield, or in Tass' case, his cape. With stalactites, well, I've gotten lucky, but sometimes it seems like no matter how quickly you start running to the left, you still get hit by them. And there's not really a lot you can do about it. And his third attack is just charging forward a little bit. Now, whew, that was close. It's impossible to predict what he's about to do either. He can do between 1 and 6 attacks. He can do two stalactite drops in a row. He can do 1 stalactite drop and then immediately turn back to normal. It seems like he always does at least 1 stalactite attack. He never just starts doing the fireballs right away. But yeah, all you can really do is run to the left and pray that you can outrun the stalactites. And then once you draw him out to a certain point, then you have to repeat this process of slowly following him back to the right. I should probably eat something just to bring myself up a little bit. That'll give me one more hit before I have to use a better item. Typically, if he doesn't immediately charge forward, then I start running to the left again, just to be safe. It's possible that he is reverting back to normal Goradus. It's possible that he's spitting fireballs. You just don't really have a way of knowing, so better safe than sorry. Luckily, he'll never press you all the way to the left side of the screen, which would cause you to leave and lose all of your progress in the boss battle. At a certain point, he always starts heading back to the right. And you can't shoot through him because of that. Actually, I wonder, it's too bad I don't still have my dino cane. I'd be interested in seeing if its projectiles could go through Goradus' head or his armor plating there. But I already sold it. Oh well, it's no big deal. We'll just have to be a little more patient. And I've gotten pretty close. See, I was running left as quickly as I could, and I still got hit in the head. Let's use a cherry. Bring us back up to 80. I think 4 more hits and I got him. It looked like he was down to 11. Somewhere around there. And my attacks do 3 points of damage apiece, I believe. And Mail's weapon is no more useful here. She has the boomerang, but it, yep. Just as useless against Goradus' backside. And the reason I like Tap for this fight is because his weapon is just a little faster. And you need all the speed you can get in this fight. Oh god! Yes! Got him. And all it cost me was an orange and a cherry. Wasted Goradus. Yes, I did. I balled him up and threw him right in the wastebasket. File 13. And nowhere else to go here. All we can do is head back to Gaw Village and bask in their admiration. Actually, let's switch to Mail for this one, just for the different dialogue. Change things up a little bit. Oops. I forgot that takes you back to the map. I don't think there are any enemies between here and Gaw Village. I don't know, it's been a while. Okay, this was where I fought the Thunder Dragon, so yeah, here we go. Hanji, thanks for the vote of confidence. Oh, thank you. Yes, I am amazing.
You did it! Oh, I knew you had it in ya. I kinda have a sense about these things, you know. It runs in the family.
God didn't think you had a chance. God promised to give you Muttonhead if you won. God will deliver. Now, I'll help you on your quest. Yes, 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 God. Okay, but wait a minute. Oh, Slicky. Yoo-hoo. My hammer. Remember? The one you snatched out of my hands? Hand it over.
Hey, that was a gift, remember?
It most certainly was not, you tweezerhead. I need that hammer to get to Muttonhead. Now give it to me.
Well, you could ask a little nicer. But as thanks for all the help you've given me, and I'm not sure that I needed it, I'd like to present this hammer to you as a gift.
Gift? Gift? Okay, buddy, just cut the crap and give me back my hammer.
Hammer time. Oh good, I don't have to actually walk back there.
Oh no, Bountyville. Who could have done this? Certainly not an ordinary gang.
It is a mystery, but the people who could explain it are gone.
All gone.
This place is gutted. It would take an army to do this. But who were they?
Muttonhead, I know you're involved in this somehow, so come clean. What happened?
This destruction is just a small demonstration of my new power!
Get a grip. You're strong, but you don't have that much power.
Wait, I think I'm putting this together. I bet this has something to do with that Kaiser fellow and the legend of the one called the Overlord.
Well, you guessed right. Give that boy a shiny gold star.
Tato, who is this Overlord anyway?
It's from the legend of the ancient wars. The Overlord was leader of a powerful trio of beings who tried to conquer our world. They were stopped by an elf, a dwarf, and a warrior, then banished from our dimension with the Black Seal.
If that's true, we have trouble! In Gar Cave, Prunehead was shouting. He bragged about breaking a black seal to bring bad spooks.
Is that true?
You know! don't have a clue. I planned the whole thing. The Overlord's back and he owes me a big favor.
Well, I could arrange for you to join him. Get the point?
Please! I'm just a weak and powerless old man. Didn't your mother ever teach you to show a little respect for your elders?
Well, since you can't shield us from the Overlord's power, we might as well send you back to him.
Oh, you can't send me back to him. He'd mock my failure to stop you, then kill me.
Well, I could spare you the humiliation by killing you now.
Wait, Mail! Although he doesn't deserve it, please give him another chance.
All right, Tad, you got it. Just one more chance.
Thank you. Your kindness will be repaid someday.
Buzzkill.
Now then, since the seal has been broken, it seems we must learn how to reactivate it. Legend speaks of it being crafted by a dwarf.
But do you think he's still alive?
If he is alive, he'd be at the sanctuary in the old mines.
Well then, looks like that's where we're headed. The mines.
But Mail, I thought you...
Hey, don't get me wrong here, Tatters. I'm not doing this to save the world. Anyone who's known as the Overlord is bound to have tons of treasure. I bet it makes the reward for Muttonhead look like pocket change. And who knows, Tat? I might even be persuaded to share a little bit of it with you. So let's get this show on the road.
Great. Just lead the way, Mail.
Tat! Oh, you spineless weasel! I taught you everything you know, and now you're going to let me rot in this cage while you prance around the land playing magic, boy? You can't do this to me!
I'm terribly sorry, Master, but we must stop what you have started before it's too late.
But I'll starve to death!
Hey, don't worry. Alive or dead, I'll still get my 2 mil. We'll be back when the seal's restored. See you later, Smarty.
Damn, Mel. Stone cold. You a stone cold killer. Alright, and that brings us to area number 3. The mine. And that does it for this week's edition, or today's edition, of Let's Play Popful Mail Redux. Tune in on Friday? Yes, tune in on Friday for the stunning conclusion to whatever is about to happen. See you then.